It's Jazzy K.
I go by The Goddess.
The West Coast native, the very young.
New York, it's the Kid Ace, man.
It's your girl, Lady G.
It's your boy, Vic Smith.
It's Benji Stone.
What's up, it's your boy, Steven Joseph, and you now watching.
With the hip-hop guru herself.
Y'all tuned in to one of the best.
And you are watching Hip Hop with Lou. She's fine, she's funny, and she getting to the money.
What is up, you guys? Welcome to another episode of Hip Hop with Lou. You see how I switched up my voice. Okay, so today I'm going to bring you three, like, really good bangers. And we're going to get them on your playlist. So, let's get this episode started.
My credit score is 700, that's a big flex. I ain't signing Nike, but I got a big check. I'm pushing 30, nigga. I ain't got no kids. I got a chocolate, every goddess made from gold. We have a rinse, she bad. She cut that ass. First pick, she don't never finish last.
I'ma get it out of bitch. How I'm supposed to? You're not supposed to do that. But the way you rap that like that, that was hard. You know that feeling that you get when it's the 99 and the 2000 come on? That's that same feeling you get as soon as this song drop. This right here is for me. You get what I'm saying? If you need to shake ass and get cash, this is what you need to put on. He said my credit score is 700. That's a big flex. You goddamn right, because you can pretty much get whatever the fuck you want. If this nigga Obama was selling his car, you would definitely get approved for whatever he trying to sell you. Like, it's just a 700, nigga, that's perfect. That is a big flex. That's how you flex. Like, nigga, what is your credit score? My shit a low 6. Probably gonna drop down to a high 5. You hear what I'm saying? But a 700, yeah, that's a big flex, okay? Because he said, the only thing I'm going half on is stocks, not a baby. You get what I'm saying? So, let me tell you something, baby. My credit score is 700, and you probably gonna try to trap me with a baby. We not gonna go half on a baby right now, you understand? But we could go half on the stock market. You got your Robinhood app open. You know how it work. Yeah, that was the motherfucking board right there. When the beat start doubling up, he pull out his checklist. Is she bad? Oh, yeah. She clapped that ass? Oh, yeah. Then he said, she come in first place. She don't never finish last. Oh, yeah. So that's what he needs. So he needs you to be bad. You got to clap that ass, and you better not ever come in second place. You get what I'm saying? Because if you're not first, you last. That's one hell of a checklist right there. And the beat, what that beat do when you say it, that it was just, ooh, it just make you want to just drop that ass. You don't even know how, but when that beat start, she's like, I don't even know what the fuck was happening. But when you start saying that and then the beat start doubling up, that couldn't have been no better shit right there. So, can she fuck? Can she suck? Okay, and is she gonna be a slut for the nut? You get what I'm saying? The way he said that, you will call yourself a slut. You'd be like, yeah, I'm a slut for the, I'm a slut, because he said that shit so cool. I mean, this song is good. It's like, if you want to shake ass, this is it. And just put this on for me, please, DJ. This is like, oh yeah, you get what I'm saying? And he did, what is that oh yeah from? Oh yeah, oh yeah. It's something, it's not hitting me right now. But that oh yeah is from, like, it's giving me like a throwback hit vibe. I want to say Chopper, but it ain't Chopper. I can't remember right now. But I know it's good. When you drop the video to this song, you get what I'm saying? Unless I missed it, I don't think I did, because I looked for it, right? When you drop the video to the song, I don't even got to be in it if I could just be front row. Because I already know the ass shaking that's finna go on when you say, is she bad and do she clap that ass? I know it's finna be crazy. And I know I can't miss that. So this right here, if you see this, I need to be in there. I need to be there in the environment. Do you understand what I'm saying? Because this song too fucking good. This really, as soon as I heard it, I said, oh, I'm motherfucking sold.
On the top, I get
Let a nigga risk my neck. I spark this bitch like Dallas, Texas. I'm
bitch off in the basement. She's from the market makers. Money conversations, not with the confrontations. I'm not patient. Free me now, they waiting. Lost my heart, so my chest aching. Relapse inside this spaceship. I count blues in conversation.
Before we even get into any of the bars, I'ma tell y'all one why I fuck with this song, because I know the current situation that Doma was in. So for you to still be able to push out your first single, you get what I'm saying? For you to still be able to do that in your current situation, my brother, I am proud of you. You get what the fuck I'm saying? And then I think that's Nino West on the hook. You was kind of giving me that like Anthony Hamilton or like Life Jennings, like, but it was like a trap sound to it. It's like, you know, when you could just hear the pain in that voice, like on the hook, he does that, oh, 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 yeah, I could feel it. And then he said, if you reach for my chain, I'ma spark this bitch like Dallas, Texas. Now, I'm gonna say that was a bar, and I'm gonna say why it was a bar, because they've been tripping out there lately. I'm pretty sure it was Texas. Yeah, them niggas been tripping, so he pretty much said, if you try to snatch my chain off my neck, because it's a thing, everybody wanna snatch rapper chain. I don't really get it. It's like, you could just go get your own chain, but for some reason, everybody just want a rapper chain. It's just like, let me snatch the chain of a rapper. I don't get it. But Domo pretty much said he gonna light your ass up if you try him. And then he said, I'ma get on this beat, and I gotta bless this shit, and I'ma tell you that's exactly what you did, because I'ma tell y'all something about Domo the Rider. He know how to ride on the motherfucking beat. That speed of his flow will ride up on your ass. He really, you gotta catch how he could just speed up the bars. He could get a lot of bars out in a little bit of time. And I think that's very impressive, because it's like, I don't know, that could go into why they call you the Rider, because the way you're able to ride on the beat. I use that all the time, because I always try to figure out where y'all rap names came from. But, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, you definitely hopped on the beat, and you blessed that. That's what you did, because you knew how to bless it. I think it was Nino. He said, first of all, I don't chase these hoes, because when I went to jail, she had a baby on me. And that's exactly why he don't chase these hoes, because he was probably like, I chased her, and then she turned out to be a hoe, because she had a whole baby, and all I needed was you to hold me down while I was down here for a little bit of time. I didn't say it was going to be easy, but I say you could go have a baby, you get what I'm saying? So that's why he don't chase these hoes. Y'all gotta stop fucking up these men like this, because when they say fuck bitches get money, it comes from somewhere. You get what I'm saying? It comes from a hurt place sometimes. Okay, Domo said he feels so heartless. He had to get the shit tattooed on him. He just went to the parlor. He just went to the tattoo artist and was like, listen, I can't feel my heart no more because these hoes got me fucked up. So maybe if you just tattoo one on me, I'll feel it. Like, maybe, you get what I'm saying? Like, wear that shit on my sleeve. Literally, I don't know. Y'all was in y'all feelings on this track. It's definitely like, nigga, let's just talk that shit and let's let them have it. And you did. And then he said, I was self-made on my 10 toes. Bitch, I did this on my own 10 toes. You get what I'm saying? I was standing on my 10 toes. You had a baby on me. Everybody turned their back on me. I had to do this shit myself. He's still doing this shit himself. They doing their shit. Sometimes that's all you need is your 10 toes and yourself. You on your shit, and you not letting nothing stop you, and that's what I respect the most. I tell you all the time, you have my fucking support forever, because to see the shit y'all be doing in fucked up situations, the shit is just, it's beautiful. It's like a fucked up situation, but y'all make the best of it.
I don't give a fuck about none of that shit. About none of that shit.
I got a certain playlist that I won't play. There's certain songs that I won't play during my celebration of life. And I'm gonna tell y'all right now, this better be motherfucking on there. Cause I don't give a fuck about none of that shit. This my life move. About none of that shit. All that negative shit. I don't give a fuck about none of that shit. You know what I'm saying? Y'all be pissing me off, and it's just like, I don't give a fuck about none of that shit. I'm gonna play this song every morning when I wake up. I have been doing it for the past 3 days. I've been waking up and I'll be like, I don't give a fuck about none of that shit again. I don't give a fuck again. I don't give a fuck about none of that shit. Okay, repeat. Let me tell you something, Asia doll. I don't know how the fuck You just turned into the female King Von. Actually, I do. Because the way that man loved you, I could fucking see that. I can't even believe you. I'm a motherfucking fan of you, baby girl. I ain't even listened to Asian Doll before. But when I heard her drop this, none of that shit, I said, I don't give a fuck about none of that shit. I'm a fan. I don't give a fuck about none of that shit they talking. I'm a fan of you. You understand what I'm saying? She said, I ain't even give a fuck about this rap shit. But Von told me to go crazy with this rap shit. And let me tell you, you just went the fuck crazy. And he is definitely proud of you right now. I'm not even gonna call you Asian Doll no more. You are Queen Von to me, because I don't know how the fuck you just turned all the way into this. It's just the energy I felt like Von was in you when you was recording this. That shit crazy. If you want more, just say that, because where I'm from, we don't play that. So don't, if you want a trick, if you want a problem, just say it so we could go ahead and just air this bitch out. You know what I'm saying? We don't got to whisper. We don't got to act like we like each other. All you got to do is say that. Because I don't give a fuck about none of that shit. You know what I'm saying? When somebody tell you I don't give a fuck about none of that shit, they have blacked out. You know what I'm saying? They gone. They done clicked into another space mentally, and you better get the fuck out their way. You know what I'm saying? You don't want none of that shit. I'm a puff puff pass your nigga. You should thank me. So you get what she did with the pass, but it's not a blunt. It's your nigga. And then here, I'm done with him, so you go ahead and have him. Girl, that was a motherfucking bar. I don't even want to break down the bars on this song. I just want y'all to acknowledge her motherfucking energy. Nigga, King Von is inside of her. Do y'all see that? Do y'all hear him inside of her? That's love. I don't know. It gave me chills. I just, what the fuck? How did you do that? Like, how did you, she Queen Von. Change the name to Queen Von. Asian Doll was cute. I like it, but I think you need to change it to Queen Von. Respectfully, rest in peace, King Von. I love this motherfucking song. I love all of these songs. Make sure you guys add them to your playlist. Thank you guys for watching another episode of Hip Hop with Lou. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe. You want to watch it? See you later.